Mike Yurcich is the new offensive coordinator at Texas, and we got to talk about it after the bumper.
Don't be cornering me. Hold up. Time. You got to help me with that corner shit.
What's up, kinfolk? It's RJ Young. I'm not on step milk. Consider hitting the like and subscribe button because I upload a video every single day. It's always college football related, sports related. We have a good time. And today, I want to talk about the new offensive coordinator at Texas. One, Mike Yurcich. You know Mike Yurcich because he was an offensive coordinator at Oklahoma State for a few years before he became an offensive coordinator at Ohio State, where they just ended their season with a loss in the Fiesta Bowl, 29-23. Now, I like the hire for Texas because Mike Yurcich, one, has a great understanding of Big 12 football and what it's like to compete in this conference. And right now, Texas can't even think about winning national championships. It has to think about unseating Oklahoma as the Big 12 champion for the last 5 years in a row, which means there are a group of seniors, including redshirt seniors, who do not know what it means not to win the Big 12 championship at Oklahoma. Also means there is a group of Texas football players who don't know what it means to win a single championship. And that's obviously something that Texas, Tom Herman, and the like want to change. And Tom Herman did what a lot of coaches refuse to do when they have subpar seasons. Not losing seasons, subpar seasons. 5-7, it's easy to fire your coordinators. At 7-5, it gets a little bit more difficult. But the heat has been on Tom Herman for the last 6 weeks, quite honestly. People were going to let slide a loss to LSU, who is in the national championship game at 14-0, and has put together one of the best seasons in recent memory. They would let go a loss to Oklahoma, who was selected into the national semifinal and won a fifth straight Big 12 championship and had a Heisman finalist for the third straight year at the ceremony, to say nothing of what Oklahoma has been able to do under first-year defensive coordinator Alex Grinch with a bunch of kiddos he did not recruit, that he took from 101st in total defense to inside the top 25 before they got Molly Wapton skull-dragged by LSU 63-28 in the friggin' Peach Bowl. But another reason I like Mike Yurcich is his embrace of basketball on grass. That's not power spread, as I'm using it this time. I've used basketball on grass to describe the power spread because of its propensity to move the ball around, pass it, and run around people, right? To basically turn it into fast break football. No, I like the hire of Mike Yurcich, one, because it lets Tom Herman do the thing that I think he does better than calling offensive plays, which is recruit. I've told this story over and over, but it's Tom Herman who brought Joe Burrow to Ohio State. As a matter of fact, Tom Herman was still the offensive coordinator at Ohio State. He saw Joe Burrow play. He wanted to offer Joe Burrow. He brought his tape back to Urban Meyer and told Urban Meyer, "I found your next Alex Smith," to which Urban Meyer was like, "I don't think so. Keep looking." But they eventually brought Joe Burrow in. He was a backup, hurt his hand. Then he went on the reserve list, went to compete with Dwayne Haskins for the starting job. Looked like Dwayne Haskins was going to win the job, but Joe Burrow didn't let it last that long. He went into the portal and was this close to going to play quarterback at Cincinnati for Luke Fickell before Coach Orgeron bought him some crawfish, and he ends up leading the LSU Tigers to this historic season and winning the Heisman Trophy. Tom Herman knows how to put together a great recruiting class as well. You just take a look at what Texas has been able to do over the last 3 years in the recruiting rankings. What it's been about is development. They have not been able to develop NFL talent. And because they have not been able to develop NFL talent, they also have been beaten more often than they think they should be beaten. They've been perfectly mediocre. People know this story, right? Texas has had 10 straight seasons of at least four losses, and that's just not something that you've come to expect from the University of Texas. A lot of this is because the power spread that Tom Herman used to win a national championship 5 years ago is the kind of power spread that's going to get you beat now, because people are going to force you to come out of your comfort space and throw the football around, or they're just going to stack the box to try to stop the run. And that's easier to do when you have a second or even third string quarterback as your second string tailback, because of the just litany of injuries that they suffered at Texas. A lot of that's because Tom Herman put him through a death camp in August and the kids didn't have anything left to go with after the LSU game. So you were banged up defensively and offensively. And because you were banged up defensively, you were giving up 450 plus yards of offense a game, to say nothing of giving up more than 500 to Kansas in a game you had to escape at home 50-48 while you were trying to wear 1969 throwbacks to honor the 1969 national champions. Woof. So then you go and you go 7-5 against Texas Tech and still have an opportunity to go 8-5 with a win over what I think is a really good Utah team in a game that I think is going to be really good, the Alamo Bowl. Now, I say all that to say bringing in Mike Yurcich is bringing up a guy, I said basketball on grass, because he knows how to coach to your strengths. Basketball on grass, meaning basketball principles, which are not unlike Sun Tzu. If you have a team that is not very fast, crash the boards. If you have a team that is very fast, run. Doesn't matter about how many shots, doesn't matter how fast you go. You can't go fast enough. You're things that you just need to gear your offense toward and gear your team toward year to year. And Mike Yurcich has shown that he can use a run-heavy offense and beat you. He can use a Mason Rudolph and a James Washington and beat you. Coming out of Shippensburg, where he did not have a whole lot to work with, actually had to do more with less, he's taken that everywhere he's gone. Even learning the offense under Mike Gundy and then being trusted to run it. That's what Sean Gleason is in the middle of doing right now. Taking great offensive minds and saying, this is how we do it here at Oklahoma State. Learn how we do it here at Oklahoma State and then go do what you would like. And I thought that was a really big deal for Mike Gundy, because Mike Gundy is a Pat Jones guy, and a Pat Jones guy means knowing that Pat Jones played nose guard for Frank Broyles at Arkansas, and that means we run the football. And Mike Gundy, who is a quarterback, still would love to run the football more than he would like to do almost anything else. He just had a 2,000-yard back in Chuba Hubbard in a year in which, yeah, they lose the Texas Bowl, but they're still plenty capable and plenty competent. Got better this year defensively, giving up just 27 a game. Mike Yurcich comes out of that tree now. And I think the only reason that Mike Yurcich would leave Ohio State to go to Texas is to be the play caller and the offensive coordinator with no strings, right? Even Mike Gundy has what he's going to tell you to do, and you're going to run his offense. Tom Herman wouldn't bring Mike Yurcich in to run his offense. He would bring him in to say, install what you need to install, but also know what kind of athletes we have here and put them in the best positions to succeed. And I think Mike Yurcich will do that. Now we get to see whether or not Tim Beck can do the things with Sam Ellinger that he's credited with doing, because Mike Yurcich is one hell of a quarterback's coach as well. So I'm going to be interested to see how that all works out with Tim Beck essentially reporting to Mike Yurcich, who will report to Tom Herman. And we know that Tom Herman and Tim Beck were close, right? I like Mike Yurcich as your offensive coordinator and Chris Ash as your defensive coordinator. I get Tom Herman basically going back through the Ohio State coaching tree to see if he can't figure out to bring some Ohio State dust down to Austin to help them get right. But you like what they have when they're healthy defensively. I think Caden Stearns has an opportunity to be a first-round draft pick if he pulls it together this year, because this last year was one that he was injured more often than not. And the year before that, he was damn near a finalist for the Jim Thorpe Award. I would know. So there's all of that in play for you if you're Chris Ash. And when they go to what I think is going to be a four-man front match quarter scheme, something that is much easier to match up with in the Big 12, you have an opportunity to win. Now, put national championships aside if you're a Texas fan right now. Right now, you want to get back to 10 wins. You want to try to beat Oklahoma, right? If you beat Oklahoma, you win the Big 12 championship. I think everybody's going to be very excited about that. But what Tom Herman cannot afford to do is to put together another 7-5 year, because another 7-5 year is going to get him fired, okay? Just like a 7-5 year got Todd Orlando his walking papers, got Tim Beck demoted, and got a couple of dudes in Drew Meringer and Corby Meegans told, hey, you guys can go over here for a second. And in the case of Drew Meringer, take a walk, you know? And that was a guy that he had known for some time that he had coached with. Yes, he's Machiavellian in his approach, but Tom Herman is also a character. Whether people want to believe it or not, this is a guy that bought a grill because he told his kids he would if they won a conference championship at Houston. He's also the guy that Zach Smith loves to drag on Twitter, but that's something else entirely. He's also the guy that threw double birds at the cameras on early signing period, the first day of early signing period. And he's also the guy that mocked Drew Locke on the sidelines in the Texas Bowl a couple years ago. There's a lot of baggage that comes with Tom Herman, so we're learning. But he does have a very strong backbone. Like Mike Gundy, he's going to do it his way. And I respect that. But I also respect saying I got to do the thing where I'm just a head coach. Because what you've learned is the guys that just are head coaches that are charismatic and go recruit can win championships. Nick Saban does that. Dabo Sweeney does that. Of course, Ed Orgeron has done that. And you know what? I really like what Mack Brown is doing in North Carolina. I think North Carolina is going to win 9 games or more next year with the kind of team that Mack Brown has put together in a very short amount of time. Jay Bateman knows how to coach. Phil Longo knows how to coach. Mack Brown knows how to recruit. That's how you build championship programs now, people. And that's where Texas is headed. Let Tom Herman do the thing where he's the figurehead, or not figurehead, because he is the head. Let him do the thing where he's in charge and he goes and recruit, and then let football people do football stuff, Mike Yurcich and Chris Ash. And then I think Texas has an opportunity to be good, but every time people say Texas is back, what do they prove? They're not, and they haven't been for 15 years. All right, that's it for me. Deuces.